In this video, you'll learn how to take one piece of creative, customize it for multiple placements without ever leaving Facebook Ads Manager. Today, I'm going to be teaching you how to take one piece of creative and use the asset customization tool to repurpose it for multiple placements. Now, make sure that you stick around to the end because I'm going to be sharing with you my biggest time-saving tip that you need to know before you upload any creative to Facebook. The first thing you're gonna need is a piece of creative. You can either select this from your Instagram profile, from your Facebook page, or you can upload something fresh from your desktop. For the purposes of this example, I'm gonna use something that's already been uploaded to my Facebook page. So we're gonna hop into Ads Manager here. We're already at the ad level inside of an ad set, which is inside of a campaign that we're running ads for. I'm gonna go here and click on Add Media. I'm gonna go Add Video. Gonna navigate to Page Videos and click on the latest video right here. Click Continue. We have our video as well as what it's gonna look like across multiple placements. This video in question is already 1080 pixels by 1080 pixels, which means it's taking up a really decent chunk of newsfeed real estate. At this point in time, the maximum amount of newsfeed real estate that you can capture vertically in the Facebook and Instagram feed is 1350 pixels high by 1080 pixels across. And go through and populate it with some text. Now this video specifically is promoting my session at Social Media Marketing World 2020. If you've never been to Social Media Marketing World in San Diego, I 100% recommend you check it out. It's an absolute blast. Links in the description to learn more for 2021. I've got a piece of content here, which is a video promoting my talk at Social Media Marketing World 2020. And then the ad copy itself is more information about my session, which supports the video creative itself. Now I've chosen not to use a call to action button because I only want people to basically like or comment and engage with this ad. I don't want to send them offsite. That's not my goal. Here's the contents uploaded. It was natively 1080 by 1080 pixels. And if we look at this, the first thing I've noticed is it's got Pokemon as the thumbnail on the ad, which is what we don't want. It's just a little meme that I included inside the creative. Go and click on edit video. So now I'm inside the edit video option. I'm gonna go and click on thumbnail. Now you can let Facebook automatically choose your thumbnail or you can choose your very own custom thumbnail. I personally love choosing a custom thumbnail so I have as much control over my creative as possible. So go ahead and click on custom. Choose the thumbnail that best represents what your ad is about. Go ahead and choose this one here, which is awesome. Click save and it's updated my thumbnail so it's now relevant. It doesn't have a Pokemon meme there anymore. And now what I wanna do is customize it for placements. The placements that you can customize it for will be based on the placements that you've selected at the ad set level. To customize by placement, you just wanna click the drop-down menu here. We're gonna click on the first one, Instagram feed. It now brings up the Instagram feed option for you to customize. So this is what my video creative currently looks like in the Instagram feed. So this piece of video creative is currently 1080 by 1080 pixels wide and high, which is capturing a decent amount of newsfeed real estate inside the Instagram feed. But let's say that I wanna capture a bit more space when people are scrolling. So what I can do is go down and crop my video and change it to say 4x5. So this is a maximum of 1350 pixels high by 1080 pixels across. I can go through and preview what the video is gonna look like and look, yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. Looks pretty decent, cool. And then it's just as simple as me going apply and it's gonna crop the video. So this is gonna take about 30 seconds or so. Basically what you wanna do now is for each placement that you wanna customize, go through and click on the placement and follow the same steps. You can customize everything from the thumbnail to how long the video is, to the size and the crop of the video, to the actual closed captions, to adding text overlay as well as logo overlay to each individual placement. Now, because this video is about a minute and 50 seconds long, it's not the best type of creative to run on an Instagram story. So I wanna customize the creative here and change it out. And the reason I wanna do that is because if you look at the preview, there's a lot going on. We've got the closed captions, we've got the video, we've got the actual text of the ad underneath. It's just a lot. I'm gonna change the creative to a static image for Instagram stories only. So I'm gonna go into page images and choose a photo that I've uploaded to my Facebook page last week. Cool, now I have the custom piece of creative for Instagram stories. I'm gonna play with it a little bit more so it looks a bit nicer. I'll go to crop and I'll change it to say vertical 916. Awesome, click save and we can see what that looks like now. See how it's cropped the Instagram story here. Let's go and click edit. Now this now makes no sense. This is why it's really important to check your ad creative before you publish it. I'm gonna change this back to the original size of the image, page images, the original size, because when I cropped it to 916, it removed the call to action text down the bottom, which means I'd just be running an image ad, which makes no sense. So it's really important to check your work. So now that we've customized Instagram stories as a placement, you just wanna go through and rinse and repeat that process, customizing each asset for each individual placement. And it's as easy as that. Now, remember earlier how I said I was gonna be sharing with you a real wicked bonus tip that's gonna save you a bunch of time before you even think about uploading any content to Facebook. You wanna keep all of your text when you're exporting a video file or when you're exporting a photo with inside the middle 1080 pixel by 1080 pixel box. Because if you don't, like I didn't in this video right here, when you go to crop it, it removes the text on the outside, which is not a great user experience at all. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you'd like to dive deeper in terms of asset customization for Instagram and Instagram stories, please go ahead and check out Susan's video here, who's got a deep dive on that exact topic. I'll see you inside there.